Len moved to Brighton with his family in 1920, the year that old guidebook was published. By then, the Palace Pier, a little over half a mile to the east, had been open for 20 years, and a rivalry had developed between them. Some said that the Palace Pier and its environs were where true Brightonians chose to take their simple pleasures. The West Pier was for the posh visitors who stayed in the grand squares of Hove, or Hove actually, as Brightonians referred sarcastically to the more salubrious town on their doorstep. For Len, there was no contest. "The West Pier was the pier, so far as I was concerned," he said. He always made a beeline for the end of the pier, past the pavilion, where there was a swimming pool with diving boards. Sometimes, proficient divers put on displays. "This Amazonian lady came there," he said, "shouting through a loud hailer. Any more for the diving in the bay at the end of the pier? She came round with a collecting box, which of course we kids ignored. She stood up there and did some dives that would not have disgraced an Olympic diver. A very high board. Somersaults. All the stuff." Len loved swimming off the end of the West Pier. The days of segregated bathing had ended 2 decades before, at the turn of the 20th century. Beaches were no longer designated male or female, and the old bathing machines, essentially wooden cabins on wheels from which one descended into the sea, now served as stationary beach huts or had been broken up. But there was still a strict etiquette about what you could wear in the sea. Men and boys were expected to cover up just as much as women. "You were not allowed to go bare-topped even then," recalled Len. "Eventually, I got the prized swimsuit, the Jensen. It had great big holes at the side, so you exposed as much as you possibly could legally." But the interwar years were a period of rapid social development that was reflected in changing habits at the seaside. Less than 20 years after a young Len Goldman was obliged to keep his torso under wraps, exposed, bronzed flesh was what holidays in Brighton were all about.